Hello, everybody. Hope you're all doing good today. This is Mama Mermaid here. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And comment if you have any questions. And I just thought I'd get on here today and talk about some general things. I wanted to talk about relationships and how important it is for us to treat one another good and to help each other along the way. Now, it's funny how things happen. You know, we had a mix-up with the mermaid group this week. You know, I'm Sammy's mom. But all that's worked out. Everything's fine. You know, the ones that needed to leave left. The ones that are still there are the ones that love all of our clients. And we try our best to manifest and, you know, help each other manifest what they do. And everything we've manifested, we've manifested. You know, we've really done it. We haven't just got out there and shot a line of bullshit. You know, I'll just be honest. It's important to be honest with people. It's important to be straight up. And whether you're trying to help somebody, you know, manifest an SP or more money in their life or whatever, honesty is always the best policy in everything. And what I teach you is what I have done. What Sammy teaches you is what she has done, okay? We teach what we have experienced. She doesn't even watch any other coaches. Now, I have a couple that I watch, but not many. And mostly, I am a Neville Goddard student. I love Neville Goddard. And I love to listen to him. Because I like to learn new things. And yes, I have always manifested it. As long as I knew, when I learned that the Bible says that our words create, I went from there. I knew that what we said came into being. If you say it enough, it will happen. That's a fact. That's not just an assumption. That is an absolute fact. So, you know, I wanted to, you know, stress that in this little video that, you know, what we teach is what we have, you know, manifested ourselves. Like, I've manifested my new car. I had already manifested two houses. The other car that I was driving, I had manifested that. I've pretty much always got anything that I really set my mind to that I wanted. And I didn't know it was called manifesting. I just knew that, you know, if you set your mind to something and you were determined, you would get it. So we just try to help people decipher between, you know, all the stories and the concepts and all that stuff. And I really love revision because I found out revision was really true. Neville talked about that. He taught that. He said that if you didn't take away anything from his teachings except that, you would still change your life. And I use it all the time. So, and that's why I do coaching on Sammy's Mermaid Gang. And anybody can reach me at mommermaidcoaching@yahoo.com. That's my website. So, with that all being said, let's talk about some SP stuff. Because that seems to be the hot topic of the day. Everybody wants to be able to have their special person. And I don't blame them. I mean, nobody needs to be alone. I don't care what your age is. Nobody needs to be alone. Everybody needs to have somebody. And the thing about, you know, the problems with SP, it starts with your self-concept, okay? We've had so many things that have been taught to us and pounded into us over the years, teaching us, you know, like, money doesn't grow on trees, you gotta work hard for money, you know, and you always assume the worst, you know, you always assume that something bad has to happen before something good has to happen. These are all false assumptions. All those old, pretty much wives' tales, they're not true. Whatever you assume in your mind is what creates your reality, your whole world. I mean, everything. It's the way everybody reacts to you. So if you naturally assume that people love you, that they honor you, that they always love and respect you. There's always going to be somebody there to help you. If you believe that you're beautiful, you're thin, no matter what you eat, you're skinny. If you keep telling yourself that, that it will happen. It happens. What you say and what you think creates your world, okay? Just trying to think of some more examples. I mean, there's just so many things. I mean, and every negative state that happens, excuse me, something's itching me. Every negative thing that happens, okay, you can always flip that around. You know, like nothing ever goes my way. Just flip that around and say, yes, everything goes my way. Every single day, everything goes my way. That's just a little simple saying. But if you say that all the time, it's going to create in your life. It has to. We are spiritual beings in a flesh body. We are constantly recreating. We were made in the image of Almighty God, the source energy of all life. And He made us to create. And we didn't even know we could do it until the last few years. So, I just think this is a beautiful thing. I mean, and I want everybody to learn that this is an option that you have. You can create your world just by simple things, you know, simple sayings, simple things thinking in your mind. You know, isn't it wonderful? Everything is perfect in my life. If you say nothing but that, every day, if you're always constantly thinking, isn't it wonderful? Everything's perfect in my life. Isn't it wonderful? Everything is perfect in my life. No matter what situation comes up, no matter how bad and how bad you want to cuss, and say things, if you will say, isn't it wonderful? Everything is perfect in my life. You know, I have seen people use just that and turn an awful situation around in just maybe an hour and turn it into something that was, everything was going their way. You know, a huge debt was, oh, somebody tells you that you owe all this money, blah, 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 blah. And you can sit there and just say, think in your mind, nope. Everything's perfect in my life. Everything's always perfect in my life. Everything has always been perfect in my life. If you sit there and constantly think that, that situation will turn around almost immediately. Because you're thinking positive thoughts. You're thinking positivity. It raises your inner, you know, some people call it vibration or whatever. It turns your mood into a higher level of consciousness, okay? So it helps you to constantly, you know, everything just, I mean, it sends out these vibes everywhere that everything just levels out. Everything just works out. And it's strange, it's like magic. It really is like magic, the way it happens. You know, but like I said, I was getting back to the SPs, you know. If you think that they are madly in love with you, if you think that they, that you're always on their mind, if you think that you are their main concern and you're constantly thinking just little things like that, oh, I'm their main concern, I'm all they think about, they're so madly in love with me, isn't it wonderful? And you have little daydreams of your, you know, maybe you two are walking down the beach and you're holding hands and everything is just wonderful, and you just imagine little scenes like that. All these things work together for us to be able to manifest. You know, it all boils back down to self-concept. Because you believed you were beautiful. You believed you were worthy. You believed that you deserved everything that you got. And so you believe all these things. And then you imagine yourself with your SP. And before you know it, you know, bam, everything is working out for you. I mean, and it's almost like, it's almost like a natural thing, like everything falls into place, and it's called what Neville referred to as bridges of incidents. But that's the way manifestation works. It doesn't come with one big fatal swoop of boom, you know. It comes with little steps, you know, little natural things. You know, this will happen, that will happen, and it'll all work together to get you what you're desiring. But remember this, the biggest thing that determines your manifestation is what have you decided on. You must decide on what you want. You can't be wishy-washy. You can't be over here, I want this car today, I want that car tomorrow. I don't know if I want that guy. I mean, I like him and he's nice, but, you know, I don't know if he's the right one. I don't know if she's the right one. You got to decide. Decide who you want. Make a concrete decision on what you want. And then when you manifest on that, and you're thinking these lovely thoughts about them, and you're saying these lovely affirmations about them, and you're doing your self-concept of building up your own integrity and your confidence, and knowing who you are and what you're worthy of. Because everything fans out to other people. It's like there's an invisible electric radiant thing that goes out. You know, when you think about somebody a lot, they think about you. So when you do all these things, it brings you into your perfect world. It really will turn you into your perfect world. Abraham Hicks, I think, refers to it as the vortex. Being in the vortex, where everything works together for you. That's all it is. That's all it is. So, anyway, I just wanted to get on here because I hadn't did a video in a little while. And I will be back, you know, doing more and more videos and explaining things. I wanted to do a more in-depth video on revision. But I really did want to get down to, you know, the very basics of manifestation. How it works. You know, what happens, you know, when you're thinking about other people. They're thinking about you. How, you know, just how things come about. And how to not, you know, get negative about it. You know, if you don't see it in the time frame that you think. I know Neville said that, you know, he gave the Bible reference to Noah in the belly of the whale 3 days. You know, and yeah, sometimes you can get it in 3 days. Sometimes you can get it in an hour. It doesn't matter. What determines how fast you get your manifestation? This is the secret. How fast you get your manifestation is how fast you have the ability to totally and absolutely believe that you have it. You got to pretend you have it, feel you have it, know you have it. That's what determines it. As soon as you get to the point to where you're 100% convinced that you have what you want, then voila, it'll show up. So, I know this video is not very long, but I just wanted to get on here and touch base with everybody and let you know, that I do personal coaching, and, you know, I love helping people to learn how to do manifestation. I really do love it. It's really helped me a lot. So if you'd like some help, let me know. But I'll be back shortly. Won't be long. I'll be making another one. And please comment. You can put on my comments what you would like for me to do a video about. What you would like to know more about. You know, because I do read my comments. So anyway, everybody have a wonderful day. And this is Mama Mermaid signing out.